Welcome back to Sports Tonight. We're broadcasting live from Channels TV Sports Center in Lagos, Nigeria. We're having fun talking sports, and you can be part of the program. Yes, you can. You can talk to us on Twitter, Channels_Sports, Facebook, Channels Life in Sports. We're talking about everything that is going down in your action-packed world of sports. The only ones we're not talking about, talk to us about it, and we will react to it. So that's the feedback mechanism right there for you on Twitter, Channels_Sports, Facebook, Channels Life in Sports. A lot of comments as regards the dwindling fortunes of Enugu Rangers. You can also be part of that discussion. MFM, they are now leaders of the Nigeria Professional Football League. What a story. Can they sustain it? That's the question a lot of you guys are asking, particularly fans of MFM. Let's see. Let's watch that team closely under the guidance of Coach Fidelis Ilechukwu. Let's see what they can do. Let's come back to African football now. Yesterday, we got the story that Mark Wilmots, former coach of Belgium, is now coach of Cote d'Ivoire. The assignment is simple, Joseph. Qualify the team for the World Cup and the next AFCON. And I think with the pedigree of Wilmots, that should be an easy job for him.
Definitely. Well, the thing is, the Ivorian team is always high profile. Definitely. We know that they have great players in the team. You know, they have a pedigree and they are not doing badly, you know, when it comes to, you know, qualification for the World Cup. It's something that is very simple, it's very straightforward, and it's got a team that is capable of doing it. I would say, to an extent, it's an underachiever with Belgium when you consider the players that they, you know, they had. They all these, you know, one would have thought that you would have at least excelled far more.
Go to the World Cup and win the World Cup.
You have the likes of Hazard, look at the team, really, in terms of players, per player in the team, you realize that they are probably one of the most, you know, star-studded teams in Europe. So, but it's okay. He was fired from his job and back in Africa now, coaching Belgium. You know, Cote d'Ivoire. I think it's a good buy for Cote d'Ivoire. Quite frankly, you know, being able to sign such a high-profile coach.
That's right.
He's definitely somebody that is capable of doing the job.
I agree. But why someone is saying it's going to be easy for Wilmots? And I would say, this is the same Cote d'Ivoire that couldn't go beyond the first round at the last AFCON. So that means there's a lot of work for him to do.
Yeah, Austin, Stephen Appiah said something about the Ivorians team even before they crashed out of the Nations Cup. He said, and I think it was very apt, that they are just a bunch of individual players, that they don't play like a team. And I think that has been the problem with the team all along, before they won the Nations Cup. The hard stars, you know, but that laissez-faire attitude, that lackadaisical attitude. You remember when they even played us, the Super Eagles, in 2013?
That's right.
Their attitude, their body language, even when they were trailing, was, you know, came to me like they're going to win the game. And before you knew it, the referee sounded the last, the final whistle. So it's not for lack of quality. They have quality.
Yeah.
But they need a coach that can, you know, make the team, the players understand that you need to play as a team. Every member of the team is important.
That's
no
right.
matter where you play, you get to play for the team. No player is, you know, bigger than the team. If they can do that, if Wilmots can do that, then they can achieve their targets.
But administratively, let's look at the FA in Cote d'Ivoire, because I can't understand how you win the Nations Cup and then the next edition you're going out in the first round. So administratively, you think this is the right job for Wilmots? It's going to come work under free conditions, and then no problem.
Well, if you are going to use the fact that they won the Nations Cup and they didn't go far in the last one, you have to also look at what happened to Spain. It's almost the same thing that happened to them. You know, when they won the World Cup, they had players in the twilight of their career. They needed to tell themselves the truth that we can't rely on some of these players. We have to ease them out gradually. When Cote d'Ivoire won the Nations Cup, Yaya Toure, Drogba, and even the goalkeeper, I forgot his name now, were in the twilight of their career. You can't rely on such players again. The energy level, age was catching up with them. And what it meant is that you look for ways, bring in younger players. You know, there should be smooth transition so that the stability of the team will be retained. But it didn't happen. And, you know, I knew that that problem will arise. So you're not going to blame that on the coach. Administratively, they had problems. You know, most African countries have that problem. You know, so Wilmots is going to learn, and he's going to learn very fast. I think this is the first time he's coaching on the African continent. So he will have to realize that things are not very smooth here administratively. Like our coach said, General Tro, he said owning coaches is not a big deal for him.
You know,
so he has realized that there are problems here. Most of the countries are funded heavily by the government. Now, sometimes there are bureaucracies, there are procedures before monies are released. So For Wimo, I mean, he's got the materials.
Yeah.
He's got to apply wisdom.
Good players.
He's got to have patience. And, I know, with luck on his side, he could get the job done.
He's always had materials. I mean, in Belgium, he had more than
But remember, he discovered most of those materials in Belgium.
Yeah, but the problem he had with Belgium was being able to make those players graduate to world beaters.
But Joseph,
you know, and he's going to face something similar in Ivory Coast. I want to believe he's a better man now, born out of the experiences had in Belgium.
Right.
Because if he's still trying to graduate, if he still has that same mentality or that inability to still get young players, you know, to play at international level successfully, he's going to have similar problem here.
Okay, so that's the update. Mark Wilmots has been unveiled as a coach of the Elephants of Cote d'Ivoire. And let's see what he can do. Objective is simple: qualify the team for the 2018 FIFA World Cup in Russia, and of course the next AFCON. Wilmots, over to you. Let's see what you can do. Let's quickly go to social media and find out what you are talking about. Joel Atla, this says, what time is the game between Nigeria and Senegal? We told you 8 p.m.
Yeah,
8 p.m. That game will be played in London tomorrow, so keep a date with the team.
Be shown live, you understand.
To be on TV?
No, it won't be.
Okay.
No confirmation yet.
No confirmation yet.
It will be streamed live on the internet.
Trust us to give you all the updates. When we get it, we'll let you know. Still, Joseph saying the way MFM are going, they will be very difficult to stop. That's a Lagos football fan right there. Let's see. Let's see how we'll come out of that. Kalamazoo, are you talking to him about the Super Eagles of Nigeria? He says no problems with the fullbacks. That is fine. That we need to do more in the midfield. But he's also worried. He says this Moses injuries just before national duties is very mysterious. Are they really genuine?
No, Austin, I think the Federation got to take a definite stance on Victor Moses. You know, I'm a big fan of Victor Moses. Highly talented. We all of us have seen what he's doing at Chelsea. But, you know, this is not the first time.
It's about the third time now.
It's not the first time he's going to, you know, pull out of games for flimsy reasons. I mean, in Europe, if you played 70 minutes, it shows that you are fit. Even if you play 10 minutes, it shows that you are fit. What it shows is that for that match, you have been certified medically, psychologically, you know, fit for the game. So what excuse is he going to give? This is not the first time. When we played, I think, Zambia away, he also came up with excuses. You know, I think when you look at his behavioral pattern, he likes playing home games. And I also want to believe that.
But this one is in London.
Yeah, could have because we are playing against Senegal and Burkina Faso. These are physical teams.
Very physical.
There are fears that he could pick up some knocks, and perhaps he doesn't want to lose his place in the Chelsea team. But I mean, these are not these are baseless.
But
it's becoming disturbing.
Yeah, we can only ask questions, but you never know because it is reported that he came with his medical certificate. So see, I don't feel too good.
Let me be excused. These European clubs, we support players who want to miss international games. That's the truth.
Okay. Still on Twitter, Joel Atlade says, thank God 3SC got the much-needed victory. Says, up shooting. Let's see. Shooting Stars, they also have some, you know, question marks here and there. Let's see if this one will spur them to keep winning. Kule says, MFM trying to pull a Leicester City in the MPFL. Good luck to them. With the hashtag Rising Stars. Last season, we called them Leicester City and it didn't end so well.
No, they shouldn't be Leicester this time around.
I know. Abodelvoy says, league has really improved. I'm so happy for MFM FC. They are skillful and vigorous, and the striker is awesome. That's what it is. When you have a good team and then you have a man that can finish it properly, that's MFM at the moment. The delight.
12 goals, 11 games. I mean, you can't bet against, you know, Steven Odeh. He's obviously the best striker in the land at the moment. That was why people were pushing for him to be, you know, drafted into the Eagles, because that position really is still very, very vacant in the Super Eagles. You know, it will help the home base Chan anyway. It will help the home base Chan. I'm sure when the camp opens for Chan, he will definitely be called up. And if he continues to perform very well, I think he might get a look in against South Africa, you know, the game that will come up before, you know, the match against Cameroon. So if he continues to play well, I mean, definitely we'll get a look in.
So when you win a lot of friends also. MFM winning so much friends on social media tonight. Benga says MFM is the only team in Nigeria presently that plays like foreign clubs because they make sure they get at least a point anywhere.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. They play with a lot of confidence.